Hello students, good morning to all. Myself Devaraja Shubha, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Punjasli College of Engineering. My subject code is CE8391, Construction Materials. Today in this class, I am going to discuss about placing and compaction of concrete. So, this is the next steps in the concrete, that is in the manufacture of concrete. The first step is the batching, and the second step is the second step is the mixing of concrete, and third step is the transportation of the concrete, and the fourth one is the placing, and fifth one is the compaction of concrete. Today we are going to discuss about this placing and compaction of concrete. So we pre-pour guidelines. Before pouring the concrete into the site, or before placing the concrete into the site, what are the guidelines we have to follow? Or you have to place the concrete as close to its final position as possible, and you have get truck or wheelbarrows as close as possible to the pouring site. We have close as possible, reach the wheelbarrow or truck to the placing site as close as possible. That is very near to the site. We have to reach this concrete. So pre-pour guidelines, tools and equipment. What are the tools or equipment for this pouring the concrete? It is a square point shovels. This is used to move materials and to fill in corners and low spots. So with the help of these only, what we will do is we will place the concrete by this, using this square point shovel. It is used to move materials and to fill in the corners and low spots. So this you all know, this is the wheelbarrow for transporting the concrete. So this is the this wheelbarrows are used to move materials where the truck and chute cannot reach. So chute and truck cannot reach, in that place this wheelbarrow will be used. So this is the chute. You all know this is chute. So pre-pour guidelines, pouring and spreading. So tools and equipments, pouring, and how will we have pour and how we spread. Start place concreting in a corner. First we have to place the concrete in a corner and work away from it. First we have to make it in corner only. We have to place the concrete. After placing in concrete corner, we have to work away from it. Then use a shovel. Already showed you the shovel. So this is a shovel. So with the help of this shovel, what we have to do is we have to spread the concrete. So do not use a garden rake or hoop, because they separate the coarse aggregate. So do not use this spade, that is a rake, spade or hoe, because they separate the coarse aggregate. You always use this shovel. So dump. So after that, what you have to use is dump each load against the previous one. Do not dump in separate piles and rake them together. So one by one, place dump it. So the level of concrete should be higher than the forms. So what this is the form work. So by doing the form work only, what we will do is, so they will form work means nothing but we will construct with the help of the this wood before for placing the concrete is to be this what form work. So the level of the concrete should be higher than the forms. So this will allow for settling, tamping and speeding. So after placing, we will do the settling, tamping and speeding process. So it should be just above, should be higher than the formwork. So next one is the tamping process. So tamping means it is the means of pushing the coarse aggregate down from the surface and bringing the fine aggregate to the top is said to be tamping. So be careful not to tamp too much. So this is tamping means just with the help of the rods. So this is tamping. So at this time, run a shovel along the inside of the forms. This will have to push back the coarse aggregate from the edges. So use a hammer to tap along the forms to help vibrate the fine aggregate to the outside surface and fill in the voids. Hammer also be used. Then hand tamp. So this is the hand tamp equipment. So this is a hand device with a rectangular piece of expanded metal which is operated while standing in the wet concrete. The expanded metal is sized to push down the coarse aggregate and allow fine aggregate to come up towards the surface. So hand tamp. Then this is the roller tamp. So it has two rollers. So it is also made up of expanded metal. As it is rolled across the surface, the gravel is pushed down. Then screeding. So screeding removes, screeding means striking off the excess aggregate. So this is the method to screeding. Screeding removes the excess concrete and fills the low spots in the forms. So it brings the surface of the concrete even with the top edge of the form. So it by this it makes the concrete very even. This is screeding. This place a board across the edge of the form. So across the edge of the form, what you have to do, you have to place a board, and what you have to do is back and forth movement is given, and after that it is slowly advanced along the slag. Make sure there is a surplus of concrete against the front face of the screed board to fill in the low spots. So screeding is done by the movement of back and forth movement. This is a screed board. Screed board is also used. So screed board is used is of a size 2" x 4" or 2" x 6" plank. So it is also used. It is recommended that this board should be purchased the day before or the morning of the pour in order to ensure a straight piece of lumber. So it should be in straight manner. So this is the plank. So this is screeding power speed. This is the power speed. So this is a device also used to strikes off the concrete when which is used for large jobs. Floating. So the floating, this is the floating method. This floating process brings the fine aggregate cement paste to the surface which allows for further finishing. So it also embed the coarse aggregate just below the surface. Additionally, it aids in leveling ridges and filling voids left by the second speed board. So a hand float is used by holding the float on the surface and swinging it in a sweeping arc. So this is the hand float. So with the light pressure is applied for floating purpose. That is, floating is nothing but leveling the ridges and filling the voids that are left by the second speed board. So this this is called a bull bloats. It's also pushed and pulled across the surface. Then this is also a floating equipment. Then this is the plank. This is a concrete float. This is the concrete float is made up of wood, aluminium. This is wood, aluminium or magnesium. So it has a rectangular base of wood or metal with a handle attached. So with the help of this, they will do the float. So hand floats are used mostly for small jobs and outside edges. So bull float. So this bull float, already told this wooden board will be there. So swivel pole handle is attached to the base. So this is also used for same purpose, floating purpose. Then joining process. So by cutting, so joining will be needed. So if the floor is of more length, what will be do is we have to provide the joint will be provided in that area. We should provide a joint. So by cutting grooves, they will cut the grooves or place joints in the slab. The location of the cracks can be controlled. So by doing this, what happens is the cracks will not be formed. So plant break permits the concrete to expand and contract without cracking. So what they do is they will make a groove, and the control joints are needed every 4 to 5 feet apart in sidewalks, and joints are needed 10 to 15 feet apart for floors, driveways or patios. So cut a joint down the center of 10 feet or longer slabs. The depth of the groves should be at least 1 by 5th the thickness of the concrete. So 1 by 5th means if the thickness of the concrete is 100 mm, the 1 by 5th into 100 is taken, and that much thickness of concrete will be grooved. So joining tools, this is a joint materials. So this is the soft wood board. So that is also provided for providing the jointing. So this is the groover, which is used to make a groove. This is the power shaft. With the help of this also the groove is made. Then next one is the finishers. So for finishing, before finishing, what type of surface we should be needed. So finishing is also the next process of manufacturing. So floating, the surface should be floated a second time before the concrete has been set, so the water and fine metals not be able to work with it. So after completing the floating and joining after placing the concrete and after compacting the concrete, what we have to do is you have to finish the concrete. So it is done, the finishing only done with the help of this wood or metal floater. The brooming is also used for rough finish in the is required than after the second floating operation. So after finishing the floating operation, second floating operation, what will we do is they will be they finish it by the help of the brooming. This is the brooming, broomer, and troweling. With the help of the trowel, they do all after floating. When the surface is semi-hot, troweling done. So troweling means it produces smooth hot surface, since the action brings the cement paste to the surface. So this process can be done with the power troweler also, which produces similar surface to the hand trowel and excellent for large job. So additional troweling will make the surface smoother and harder. However, excess troweling will leave the surface weak and easily damaged by frost and chemicals. So this is about finishers. So totally the in manufacture of concrete today in this class, I have discussed the placing, compaction and finishing of the concrete. So how we should pour the concrete, that also I have discussed, and how should tamp the guide